Ken Trahan with Lenny Van Gilder. It's a SportsNola.com First NBC Weekend Review brought to you by First NBC Bank. Thanks to Ashton Ryan and First NBC Bank for their continuing support. Well, it's a good weekend. Overall, not a total success, but a pretty good success, at least for the Saints and LSU. The Saints took care of business, an easy win at Oakland, 38-17. They took care of business, Lenny, and they created some more turnovers, and that's encouraging to see.
It is, and that was clearly a tone setter. In this game on Sunday, you know, that Malcolm Jenkins interception return for a touchdown. A couple of other opportunities, plays that got reversed. They could conceivably had four turnovers, but two, they couldn't hang on to the football, I guess. The Raider receiver was ruled to have already dropped the ball instead of catching it and fumbling it, I should say. But, you know, they made some plays on the defensive end. Yes, they gave up 400 yards again, although most, you know, a good 30% of them came in garbage time when the game was clearly in hand. Yeah, we've said this. It's not about the number of yards you give up. It's about the number of stops you make, and it's about the times you make stops. Even yesterday, you had that, you know, the interception by Roman Harper in the end zone. You don't forget the Raiders had the ball at the one-yard line at one point during that possession. So, again, you know, team down close, the Saints are able to get a stop and not just get out with three, but get out of there with zero. And those are the types of things that, you know, this defense is starting to become known for, especially over the last 5-6 weeks.
Good in the red zone, and I'll take my chances when you give up 17 points if you're the New Orleans Saints. And, of course, as a result, 5-5, big game with the 49ers coming up. The 49ers play on Monday night without Alex Smith, so they'll have a short week, and the Saints will be at home, and I'd say advantage Saints in that situation.
You would think a short week and the 49ers have to make a long trip. That certainly sets up. Now, obviously, we don't know what Alex Smith's status will be for Sunday in the Dome. This is obviously a huge three-game stretch for the Saints with the 49ers Sunday. Then you've got a short turnaround to a Thursday night game in Atlanta, followed by a game at the Meadowlands against the Giants. And the Giants are, you know, right now in a dogfight with the Cowboys for the NFC East, it looks like. So it's, you know, this is a huge 3 weeks, and it could set up an even bigger 2 weeks behind it, because if you're indeed in the hunt for the wild card, you've got Tampa Bay and Dallas in weeks 15 and 16, two of the teams that you're possibly contending with for that final wild card spot.
LSU wins on senior day. It was not easy. They did not look like they were totally ready to play initially, and they had to fight like crazy to get past Ole Miss, but they did. The sign of a good team. Offense productive again. Special teams won the game with a punt return by Odell Beckham. Defense, a lot of work to do there, but they got the win. 7-8, you know, you look at the polls, they're not going to be able to get back in at this point, and they're kicking themselves, Lenny, because had they beaten Alabama, they'd be having a great chance to play for the national championship.
They would be. Now the question becomes this. Take care of business Friday at Arkansas. Is that going to be enough to get LSU in the BCS?
No.
I'm not so sure of that. Let me tell you. It depends if, with what happened on Saturday night, that basically has gift-wrapped a spot in the BCS championship game for the SEC, if that's indeed the case, I have got to believe that all things being equal, and they're going to be pretty close to it, that the Sugar Bowl will want LSU here. And that's
no, they'll take Texas A&M, I promise you.
Okay.
Promise you. It's about tourism. It's about dollars and cents. And one of the most exciting players, if not the most exciting player in America. And I hope LSU gets the best of all worlds here and they come here or to another BCS game, but I don't see that happening on the record. Tulane lost, of course, obviously. They played representative. They competed with a pretty good team but couldn't finish the deal.
Yeah, they were decent. And I mean, there's a, you know, a lot of talk that I've seen about, you know, maybe some questionable calls on a, you know, Josh Rounds made a catch, went to turn up field, but his knee had hit the ground. The officials ruled it could have been about a 30-yard gain. Instead, ended up being fourth and short to him. Would have been in a position to take a big lead early in the game at that point. And was that a potential game changer? I don't know. You know, at the end, East Carolina was a better football team, made just enough plays to win the game. You know, Ryan Griffin, they really didn't give him a lot of deep opportunities. He had to kind of dink and dunk the whole game, completed a lot of passes, but didn't quite get to 300 yards passing. So it was a pretty good scheme by East Carolina, and they did just enough to win.
Tulane just can't run the ball at all. And, of course, they close out their season at Houston this coming weekend. The Hornets have lost three straight, back in action against the Knicks on Tuesday night at New Orleans Arena. Knicks are 7-1. That will be tough. High school football quarterfinals set now for this coming Friday night. And I guess the big highlight there as we close out would be 4A, where you've got, counting Vanderbilt Catholic, five of the eight teams here from this area.
Exactly. You've got, and I think I counted right, five opportunities to see games Friday night without having to go very far at all. Curtis will be at home. Holy Cross will be at home. Carver will be at home. McDonough 35 will be at home. And Carr will be at home. That Carr-St. Aug game should be a terrific game to watch Friday night with some great talent on the field, and only one of those teams is going on in the semifinals.
Great job, Riverside. Bill Stubbs, phenomenal job with that young team to get to the quarterfinals, and the reward is playing Curtis again. Good luck with that, but a great season nonetheless, and we'll see what happens. Of course, watch SportsNola.tv.com.everything. SportsNola TV, Monday night, 6 p.m., WHNO Channel 20. We'll talk about high school, college, pro, the Saints, Hornets, you name it, we'll do it. That's 6 p.m., WHNO Channel 20 on Monday night. And this has been our first NBC Weekend Review, brought to you by First NBC Bank, with 30 locations throughout the metropolitan area and beyond. Lenny, thank you.
See you later this week.
He's Lenny. I'm Kenny. Have a great day. God bless.